Hi, I'm Nick with TrailCamPro.com. Today we're going to talk about how to repair Browning trail cameras, specifically the PIR lens. One of the biggest things we see in the field is a woodpecker or something knocking a PIR lens out, which could cause a few problems. One, there's now an easy entry for moisture to get into a camera, and two, it can certainly mess up the detection capabilities of the camera. So we'll walk you through how to do this. It's fairly simple, but seeing it in person will help a little bit. So, few things that we need: a really small screwdriver, because there's gonna be, it looks like, six screws on the back. There'll be one on the front that we need to take out. You might have to modify a screwdriver like we did, but it's gonna be very small. I would check like a Harbor Freight or something. And then we got a little bit of tweezers, a flathead, and a little tray to catch everything. And we got a little magnet on this screwdriver just so I don't drop things with my clumsy fingers. So let's get started. All right, so on the back, you should see six holes. They have small Phillips screws in there. And I'm just gonna start by simply unscrewing those. All right, so I've got the six screws out in the back. This particular Browning is a Browning Strikeforce HD Pro X. And this one has a little screw right here that I'm gonna take out. Same way. You can see the screw is a little bit different, so just note that's the one that goes in the front. These are the ones that go in the back. And there you can see that pops out quite nicely. All right, so we've got this open, and now there are some somewhat concealed black screws on the inside here that we're gonna take off. I'm gonna be very careful and not mess with any of the wiring or really anything else that I don't have to. So I'm just going to simply unscrew and then obviously save these screws. Only take out the exterior screws to the circuit board. Don't take out these two screws as they hold in the lens on the other side. All right, so once you've got all the screws out, and if you find any screws that are shorter than another, like I did, I would separate them and make sure you get them back in their exact places. We're wanting to remove this circuit board. It's really important that you don't touch this front-facing part of the circuit board with your fingers or anything else, so I'm gonna be very careful to avoid that. However, there is this little piece of tape right here that I'm gonna try to peel back. Once I get that peeled back, it's just so that I can get this kind of separated so we can get to the underside part of this PIR lens. So I'm gonna try that. And this is where like tweezers, the small flathead might come in handy. Like so. And then, being careful not to disturb these wires any more than I have to. And if I have to handle it with my fingers, I'm gonna try to do it on the edge of the circuit board. So you can see I'm stretched to the max here on this wire. I don't wanna overextend it. Don't want anything to pop out. That would be catastrophic. All right, so you should see there's two black screws right here. I'm going to carefully remove them. So one important part of the process is this little plastic piece that sits on the inside of the PIR lens. Before we remove this, we actually made a small mark on it so we knew which way it was facing. And I would recommend you do the same with a little Sharpie or something. Just give it a little dab so that you can put it back in exactly the same orientation that it was to begin with.
Use these tweezers once again to try to get this removed. Like so.
And so once that's out, I'll set it to the side and I'm ready to remove the actual PIR lens. So I can actually now push on it from the underside and feel it kind of pop loose. And you can either bring it out the top like this, or if you just kind of move it to the side, it should fall out the bottom like so. And so here is the PIR lens. This particular one is obviously not broke, but you would throw this one away. The one that you purchased for a few bucks on Browning's website, you could now replace back in there. So you just simply drop it in there. You might use tweezers to help set it in place. Kind of work from both the front and the back there with the tweezers, and then your hand on the kind of the bottom here. And just be really careful. There's no rush in any of this. Let's just make sure we get it in without damaging any of this circuit board.
I can check it kind of from the bottom without stretching these. And it does look good. So now I can take this little plastic piece again. We will drop it back in gently. And we're going to reverse the process. So it does help, on, especially on these small screws in this part of the process, if you have a screwdriver that has a magnetic tip. All right, so I'm just snugging it. I'm not trying to show how strong I am here. This is just a nice snug. Make sure that sits in properly. So I want to check it again just to make sure that this looks level. And it does. It's like an even gap all the way around. So now I'm going to try to get this circuit board back in its original spot. And I'll reattach the tape when I get it there. All right, so we're going to get this all reattached. Back together. So I'm going to start next with this front screw, which is in this case, on this particular Strikeforce Pro X, the smallest little one. All right. So once that is in, before I put these other screws in, I do want to make sure that I get that this little gap right here even all the way around. And it did. So might just close that back up. Go back and replace these screws and test the camera out, and we should be done. So I'm just again snugging these screws up. They don't need to be too tight. And once I've confirmed they are all in there about the pressure I like, then we should be good. And if you've done this, what I would simply do is obviously check your PIR again and then take it outside for a walk test, just walking back and forth in front of it. And hopefully if everything went according to plan, it worked. All right, well, hopefully this helps, and good luck if you perform this surgery. Just be sure you don't do it while you're in a rush. Take your time, make sure you don't break anything. If you have any questions, you can always give us a call, 417-429-4915. We'd be happy to help any of our customers. And then obviously, if you're looking for a new trail camera, check us out, trailcampro.com. We offer 2-year warranty on all our cameras, a 90-day return policy, unlimited customer support. You can always give us a call and talk to any one of us. So we will see you soon. Thanks for watching. So today we're talking about a PIR lens, and you can see this one's perfectly good.
How do you feel about me replacing Brad?
It's like a lose-lose situation.
Win-win, not lose-lose. I'm basically making Nick look good with my videoing skills today. So,
Brad could have never done this. Oh, the screws are too big for his hands.
Cut, because I'm going to go eat lunch.